So we're going to change this to breadth first search, but we're going to do it really easily, at least for the people version, by grabbing the first element off the open list instead of the last element off the open list. And let's take a look at how that changes things. All right, so we start off with D as the first thing added to the list and D on the open list. And now what we do is, well, the first and the last element are the same, so nothing changed yet. So we grab D off, we mark any unmarked neighbors of that node of D, which in this case are E and C, just as before. And that's done for this time through. And now we go back up to the top and things get a little different. This time, well, actually not that different. The order was sort of arbitrary, and so first and last are sort of arbitrary. But we're going to grab the first thing off the list, just like the instructions say, and that's E. Add its neighbors in. The neighbors get, they still get added to the end of the list. So that's a little different in terms of the numbering so far, but now is where it gets even differenter. We go back up to the top and we grab the first element off the list, which in this case is C. So we alternated. Instead of continuing in one direction, we're actually expanding outward from D. We did D and then C and E and then B and F. And now what happens next is we expand from F. We've expanded G, added it to the end of the list. But now before we touch G, we're always pulling off the front of the list now, we get to B. All right, now we visited everything. The next thing we pull off is G. We notice it has no open neighbors. Then we pull off A. We notice that it has no open neighbors. And the open list is empty. The search has finished. And you can see what happened in this case is we expanded out from D, and now A and G, well, the sum of those A and G are 13 instead of 12, which is not a really significant or meaningful difference at this point, but it is indicating that the search is proceeding differently. And the way it's proceeding, importantly, is out from the center. All the paths that it found, all the edges that it expanded, it knew shortest distance it was away from the beginning state. So this is going to give us what we need to actually find shortest paths.